there. From your beautiful mornings to the unwinding nights, we make them look picture perfect. We are Novel Group of Companies, established in 1955. As the years passed, we emerged as a manufacturing giant of sewing machines. Inspired by the latest and advanced technologies, we take pride in unleashing our bold new line of sewing machines that gives your sewing job an artistic edge. Novel designer models are a smart alternative to your local tailor. Now, no dependency on the tailor anytime. Be it alteration, patchwork, or even pattern design, these multifunction machines are always at your service. These are cost effective as they save time, energy, and money. In short, you have your style at your time and with your savings. The team at Novel believes that the relationship does not end with a sale, but just begins. Novel is headquartered in Pune, but has branches in multiple cities across India to serve you all better. Thank you for buying Novel Designer Models. But before starting up with the easy demonstration of how to use the machines, let us understand the various parts of the machine.
Thank you for buying the Novel Auto Designer machine. This is the Novel Auto 10 model. Plugging your machine. The foot controller plugs into the side of the machine and then in the wall socket. Then turn on the machine by using the power switch. Presser foot lifter. The presser foot lifter located at the back of the machine is used to raise and lower the presser foot at the time of sewing. Pattern selector dial. This is the pattern selector dial. This dial is used for selecting the design you wish to sew. Tension dial. This is the tension dial. The tension dial is used to loosen and tighten the stitch whenever needed. But for most of the stitches, you can just leave the tension dial anywhere between 3 to 5. Reverse button. The reverse button located at the front side of your machine is used to sew the stitches in reverse, backward direction, which helps in locking your stitch. Hand wheel. The hand wheel is always used to manually move your machine's needle in upward and downward direction. Extension table. This is the removable extension table, which can be used to stitch in circular direction for sleeves, pants, hems, or children's clothing. This extension table is also used for storing your machine's accessories. Easy to carry handle. The Novel Auto Designer machine, being a lightweight machine, is also provided with easy to carry handle, which helps you in easy access while moving your machine from one place to another. Bobbin winding. The first step to start stitching in any sewing machine is with threading the bobbin. Novel Designer Auto model uses a transparent plastic bobbin, so be sure of buying the same type of bobbin from your retailer whenever needed. Place your thread spool on the thread spindle A. Then pull the thread to the left and wrap it around the bobbin winder tension disc. Now put the thread end through the bobbin like this, and then place the bobbin on the bobbin winding spindle and push the bobbin to the right to start threading your bobbin. Before stepping on the foot controller, it is very important to check if the bobbin winding switch is on. To do this, simply pull your hand wheel in outward direction to your right to switch on the bobbin winding mode. Now, step on the foot controller slowly to start winding. The bobbin will stop automatically once it has been completely filled. Before removing the bobbin from the spindle, push the bobbin to your left and cut the thread, and also push the hand wheel to your left to lock it in. This will now attach the hand wheel back to the machine, which means that the needle will now start moving up and down after stepping on the foot controller. To insert or remove the bobbin from the shuttle, please make sure that the needle is at its highest position by turning the hand wheel counterclockwise. Now, remove the extension table from the machine and then open the shuttle cover. Hold the bobbin case tab to remove the bobbin case. Insert the filled bobbin so that the thread moves in clockwise direction. Now, pull the thread through the bobbin case, slit, and then under the finger. Hold the bobbin case with the latch and insert into the shuttle. Close the shuttle cover and then put back the extension table. The process of bobbin winding has now been completed. Threading the machine and swing. Raise the pressure foot lifter located at the back and then pull the thread to your left from the thread spool through the upper thread guide 1 and then down through the tension disc. Follow the slit till the end and then around the U-turn and back up. Bring the thread from the right to left so that the thread slips into the take-up lever easily. Bring the thread back down till the end and slip it behind the horizontal needle clamp guide. Thread the needle from the front to back, pulling about 6 to 8 inches through the eye of the needle. Now, you will need to raise the bobbin thread from the shuttle. To do this, hold the upper thread with your left hand and move the hand wheel counterclockwise till the needle moves all the way down to its lowest position. Then, raise the needle back up to the top. Pull the needle thread with your left hand. This will draw up the bobbin thread through the needle plate hole. After raising the thread from the bobbin case, lift the presser feet using the lifter located behind the machine and place both the threads under the presser foot and towards the back. And your machine is now ready to sew. Sewing. Place your fabric under the presser foot. Lower the presser foot using the lifter and then select your design using the stitch dial and step on the foot controller slowly to begin sewing. After completing your stitch and before removing any fabric from the machine, be sure to move the hand wheel counterclockwise until the needle is at its highest position and begins to descend. Then raise the presser foot lifter located at the back to remove the fabric. This process will help avoid any thread jamming the next time you sew. Now we will learn how to operate the different type of presser foot. All-purpose presser foot. The all-purpose presser foot can be used for both straight stitch and zigzag stitch. These type of stitches are most frequently used. Place the desired foot on the needle plate aligning the foot holder with the presser foot pin. Then, lower the presser foot lifter located at the back so that the foot holder snaps on the foot. The process of changing the presser foot has now been completed. For straight stitch sewing, first attach the all-purpose presser foot using the snap-on lever. Then, set the pattern selector dial on A and the thread tension dial between 3 and 5. Then, select the stitch length dial anywhere between 1 to 4 depending on your requirement. Now, before you start sewing, you will need to raise the bobbin thread from the shuttle. After putting both the threads under the presser foot and towards the back, raise the presser foot using the presser foot lifter located at the back and place your fabric under the presser foot and align it with the sewing guideline provided on the needle plate and step on the foot controller slowly to begin sewing. For simple zigzag sewing, first attach all-purpose presser foot using the snap-on lever. Then, set the pattern selector dial on B and the thread tension dial between 3 and 5. Then, select the stitch length dial anywhere between 1 to 4 depending on your requirement. Now, before you start sewing, you will need to raise the bobbin thread from the shuttle. After putting both the threads under the presser foot and towards the back, raise the presser foot using the presser foot lifter and place your fabric under the presser foot. Lower the presser foot using the lifter and step on the foot controller slowly to begin sewing. Rolled hemming presser foot picot. For rolled hemming picot, place the rolled hemming presser foot on the needle plate, aligning the foot holder with the presser foot pin. Then lower the presser foot lifter to snap hold the rolled hemming foot. Then set the pattern selector dial on B. Then select the thread tension dial between 3 and 5 and the stitch length dial anywhere between 1 to 4 depending on your requirement. Again, before you start sewing, please do remember to raise the bobbin thread from the shuttle. Now, place your fabric under the presser foot and lower your needle on the fabric where the sewing needs to begin. At first, sew 3 to 4 stitches using the hand wheel counter clockwise, pulling both the threads, needle thread and bobbin thread. With your left hand, then slowly press the foot controller to start stitching. While stitching, fold the fabric a little to the left and allow it to run into the hemmer foot. Please check that the fabric is running into the scroll of the hemmer foot properly for better results. 4-step buttonhole. The most commonly used style is the bar tack buttonhole. For stitching a 4-step buttonhole, first place the buttonhole foot on the needle plate and attach it to the presser foot lifter. Set the thread tension dial between 3 to 5. Now, mark the buttonhole on the fabric and position the foot over the fabric using the marked area. Now, if you look closely on the stitch dial, there is a rectangular marking. Simply select it first and then select 1 on the pattern selector dial to sew the first step of the buttonhole. Then, with the needles raised on the fabric, select 2 on the pattern selector to sew the second step of the buttonhole. After completing the second step, raise the needle out of the fabric and set the pattern selector dial on 3 to sew the third step of the buttonhole. When step 3 is complete, raise the needle out of the fabric and again select 4 to sew the fourth and the last step of the buttonhole. After completing step 4, raise the needle out of the fabric and cut the threads. Cut the opening with the seam cutter and your buttonhole is ready. Now, let us see the process of changing the needle. Firstly, make sure that the needle is at its highest position. Use the screwdriver provided with the machine and loosen the needle clamp screw to remove the needle. Please note that the needle has two sides. One is the flat side and the other is the round shaped side. Place the flat side of the needle facing inside and push the needle into the needle bar and tighten the screw. The same process can be done to change needles in all the novel designer auto models. Let us see how to take care of your novel designer auto machine. First step towards maintaining your machine is to unplug it. Then, to remove the shuttle race hook, you have to take the needle to the highest position using the hand wheel and moving it counterclockwise. Remove the extension table and open the shuttle cover. Hold the bobbin case with the latch and remove the bobbin case. Then, open the hook ring holders and remove the shuttle race hook. clean the shuttle ring and the hook with the brush provided with the machine accessories, or use a soft dry cloth to do the same. To put the shuttle hook back in the machine, hold the hook with the center pin and fit it back carefully into the shuttle driver, forming a circle. Remember to check that the needle is at its highest position when you are putting back the shuttle hook, or else it'll get damaged. Now, align the shuttle ring with the hook, making sure that the back pin fits into the notch. Then, lock the ring by turning the holders back into position and insert the bobbin case. Shut the shuttle cover and put back the extension table.
Now revamp your wardrobe in no time with these intelligently designed novel machines. So how about owning this revolutionary sewing machine? Contact us now.